The Luba. Once upon a time, about 500 years ago, the African time travel machine brought the Marcus Garvey Cubs to the Luba Kingdom in Central Africa. The Luba Kingdom was known for its metals. They used their metals to make tools, pots, and even art. The Luba also had lots of salt that they traded with other people from near and far. When the Garvey Cubs visited, they wanted to learn how the Luba people lived and how they grew into such a large and powerful kingdom. Tana said,
"You know, I also want to study the different kinds of fish and plant life they have in the Luba-Luba lakes."
Zumbi said,
"I want to study the iron and the gold to see if as good as the metals in other parts of Africa."
Besides the Luba-Luba lakes, the Luba kingdom also had thick rainforests and lots of grassy land with all kinds of animals. While the cubs were looking around, someone said,
"Hello there. Welcome to the Luba Kingdom. You must be the Marcus Garvey Cubs. I am Miss Mutumbo."
Morel said,
"You have a beautiful, beautiful kingdom,"
Miss Mutumbo told the cubs.
"The king wants to see you in the morning. He wants to welcome you to the Luba Kingdom. He is a very strong and jolly king."
Angola said,
"Great! We would be glad to meet him. We brought a gift for him and the queen."
"Oh, he will be happy to hear that. He loves getting gifts, but he enjoys giving them even more. I will see you cubs tomorrow."
The next morning, the Garvey cubs went to see the king in his palace. They didn't even have to wait outside of the palace for the guards to tell them to come in, because the king was already outside waiting to meet them.
"Welcome, cubs! Welcome, Garvey cubs! Happy to see you here in Lubaland!"
The king was a big black man with a small beard. He had a big smile on his round face.
"Come in, please! Please come in!"
The cubs followed the king down a long blue carpet. While they walked down the carpet, the king's royal drummers were drumming slowly and quietly. At the end of the carpet, the queen was standing there with her arms stretched out.
"Welcome, cubs! Welcome!"
She grabbed every one of them and hugged them tightly and kissed their cheeks on both sides. Before the cubs could sit down, they heard the drums getting louder and faster. Then, 25 young men and 25 young women came into the big hall and started to sing some of the queen's favorite Luba songs. 10 of them got into a circle and started doing the queen's favorite African Luba dances. They danced to the beat of the drums. The drums sounded so nice that Nefertari and the queen started their own dance. Before they knew it, the king and all of the cubs had joined in the dancing. Well, all except Angolo. He reached into his backpack and took his video camera out.
"I want to make a video of the king dancing so I can take the video pictures back for people to see."
But all of a sudden, one of the king's guards grabbed Angolo and picked him up off the ground. Another guard took his video camera out of his hand. Angolo shouted,
"Help! Help!"
The king heard Angolo and the guards.
"Halt! Stop everything!"
All the drummers stopped. All the singers stopped. And nobody moved.
"Guards, let the boy go! Now!"
The guard put Angolo down.
"But your majesty, he was pointing something at you. I thought it was something that could hurt you and the queen."
Angolo said,
"Oh, sorry, your majesty. This is something from the future. It's a video camera, and we are going to give one just like it to you and the queen."
The king slowly walked over to see it. Then Angolo opened a little screen on the side of the video camera. Everybody was quiet. Angolo pushed a button on the camera and showed the king a video of himself, the king, dancing and singing with everyone else. The king's face lit up and he started laughing.
"Hey, hey, hey, queen, come look. It is us and the cubs dancing. Quick, before it goes away."
Angolo smiled.
"Don't worry, your majesty. I can play it over again."
Then Tana handed the king the video camera they brought to him as a gift.
"King, this one is for you. Let me show you how it works."
Tana showed him how his new gift worked. The queen also tried it out. She took a video of the king singing one of his favorite songs. The king was happy. He looked at Angolo.
"Angolo, African people from your time in the future. How long have they been making these video cameras?
N'Golo stopped smiling.
Sorry, Your Majesty. Right now, African people don't make them.
What? What do you mean?
Well, King, they are mostly made by Europeans and Asians.
Who?
Europeans and Asians. They make them and sell them to us.
I don't understand. African people like to use them, right?
Yes, Your Highness.
Then you should just make them yourselves. Don't wait for other people to make for you what you want or need. Make it for yourselves. Do you understand?
Yes, Your Majesty. Marcus Garvey taught us the same thing.
Well, good for him. So when you grow up, make your own, okay?
Yes, Your Majesty. We promise we will.
Soon, the cubs left the palace. For the next 3 days, the cubs walked all over Lubaland. There were many different kinds of animals around, and they wanted to video record every kind they saw. Karinda had an idea.
Hey, you guys, let's try to take a video of animals in action, you know, while they're doing things. Let's try to get some video of them while they're playing or eating, or maybe we'll see a lion trying to catch a deer or an antelope or something.
Morel said,
you know, that is a good idea, because when the people back home see these videos, they like to see action.
Back at the palace, the king and queen watched the video that the cubs made. Even the royal cat liked watching the video. The cubs also left a few other videos for the king and the queen to watch. The video showed how people lived from where the cubs came from. There were videos of birthday parties, spelling bees, football games, marching bands, and children playing games like jump rope and tag. Tag is a game where one child chases the other children. When he touches one of them, he screams, "Tag, you're it!" Then the one who was tagged now tries to catch someone else to tag. The king, the queen, and the cat loved watching all of the videos. Now, the cubs took their cameras everywhere. N'Golo, Tana, and Salim took theirs to the forest. Tana said,
"Look, there are some baboons and monkeys playing in that tree. I will video record them playing. Children at home will love that."
Then, when they were about to leave the forest, a spotted leopard came very quietly from behind the bush. Salim said,
"Watch, it is slowly creeping up that tree. The monkeys don't even see it."
Then, all of a sudden, the leopard jumped on the tree trunk and started running up the tree after the monkeys. When the monkeys saw the leopard, they screamed and ran out to the end of the branch on the tree. First, the leopards followed them on the big branches, but then the monkeys jumped over to the small branches on the next tree. Salim said,
"If the leopard tries to go far out on that tree branch, it will have to stop, because if the branch breaks, it will fall all the way to the ground."
So the leopard slowly, very carefully, climbed back to the bigger, stronger branch. Then he jumped back to the tree's trunk and climbed back down. Now the monkeys were free. They got away.
Wow, did you guys see that? That was cool.
Salim was watching it with the video camera.
Yep, I saw it all, N'Golo, and I got it on the video.
Great, Salim. Good job. That's going to be one of our best videos.
When the cubs came out of the forest, Salim gave Tana the video camera. She looked up and covered her eyes, because when she came out of the dark forest, the sun really seemed bright. One of the Lulalaba lakes was close by. Tana looked up and saw a big silver bird flying high in the sky. N'Golo looked up and saw it too.
Wow, look at the size of that bird. Is that an eagle or a vulture? I can't tell from here.
Then Tana pointed the video camera at the bird.
N'Golo, I want to get this on camera. Look at it fly.
While she was watching, the bird suddenly flew down at the water as fast as it could fly.
Look, it's swooping down to the lake, trying to get a fish.
Salim could see it more closely now.
I can see it better now. It's an eagle. Look at the size of those wings.
The eagle swooped down in the water after the fish, but the fish saw it coming and dived deeper into the water. The eagle hit the water and came up, but there was no fish in his sharp claws. Tana shouted,
I got all that on video.
N'Golo was excited.
Now we have two great videos to take back home. Wait till the rest of the cubs see this.
Now, over on the other side of the lake, Tamika, Morel, and Corinda were watching something else. Corinda had the video camera. A big brown and green scaly crocodile was laying on the side of the lake. It had not moved for a long time. It was watching some of the long-legged birds called storks walking around in the water. Morel said,
"That crocodile is trying to be as quiet as he can. He is hiding most of his body down in the mud, but you can still see his long mouth and his big sharp teeth."
The crocodile just waited and waited and waited. Soon, one of the long-legged storks walked a little too close to the side of the lake, and the crocodile slid deeper under the water, but very slowly. He quietly floated closer to the bird. Then, when he thought he was close enough, he jumped up at the bird with his mouth wide open, and then his big mouth chomped closed. But the stork jumped away just in time. The crocodile tried again, but by now the stork flapped his wings and flew up out of the water. Now it was safe from the crocodile.
"Wow, Corinda, Tamika, did you see that? That stork just got away."
Tamika's mouth was open, but no sound came out because she was so surprised at what she had just seen. Corinda said,
"Got it, I got it."
Then Tamika found her voice.
"You got that on the video camera?"
"Yep, the whole thing."
"Great."
Morel was still looking at the crocodile.
"I think that crocodile is getting a bad attitude now. I think we should leave him alone."
On the way back home, Morel, Corinda, and Tamika saw something that looked just like something they saw all the time at home. A small brown and white cat was running as fast as it could across the field, and a big gray dog was chasing it with its tongue hanging out. Every time the dog got close, the cat would make a quick turn left or right and get further away from the dog. Morel was holding the camera now.
"Well, I think I will get this on video, so that our friends at home can see that the African dogs and cats 500 years ago act just like the ones where we come from in the future."
Before the dog could catch it, the cat climbed up on a high wooden fence that the Luba farmers use to keep their cows and sheep. The dog couldn't climb, so he just stopped, looked up, and gave the cat one of those goofy dog looks before he walked away.
"I guess dogs are the same everywhere, always chasing things they can never catch."
Now much further away, Zumbi, Nefertari, and Cujo were laying down low, peeking through the grass at a big lion. They were a little scared, but very quiet. They saw the lion looking at a group of zebras together in a big zebra herd. The zebras were eating grass and drinking water from a little pond by the grass. When the lion got a little closer to the zebras, it lay down in the grass to hide.
"Nefertari, do you have the video camera ready?"
"Yeah, I'm watching everything. I think the lion is going to try to catch one of those zebras, but those zebras are smart."
Cujo watched the zebras eat.
"I wonder if they even know the lion is there. They look so relaxed."
Then the lion started to move slowly. He looked like he was crawling down in the grass. One step at a time.
"Shh, quiet."
Then the lion jumped up out of the grass. He started running after the whole herd of zebras. The zebras must have known the lion was close because they jumped up and ran at the same time that he did. When the lion got close to them, two zebras confused him. Nefertari said,
"Did you see that? One zebra ran right, the other one ran left. The lion didn't know which one to chase, so he didn't get either one. Now the whole herd has run away."
Now, the lion just stood in one place, with his tongue hanging out, panting and breathing hard. Now he was tired, so he slowly walked back to the tall grass. He laid back down and took a long, long, long lion nap. Nefertari video recorded the whole thing.
"Well, everyone will see this one when we show it. Let's get back to the house."
When the cubs all got back to the house, they showed each other their videos. Ngolo said,
"You know, we should put all the animal chases on one video, and when we get back home, we can show it like a movie."
"That's a great idea, Ngolo, and we can make one for the king and queen, too. They would like seeing all of these animals running around and chasing each other."
Zumbi grinned.
"Yeah, and the king and queen and their cat. The royal cat would like watching her cat cousin run away from that goofy dog."
So they gave a video to the king and queen. The king and queen and their cat liked that video more than all the rest. They watched that animal chase video over and over and over again. The king said,
"Those Marcus Garvey cubs are fantastic. I love to watch our Luba animals in action. Crocodiles, storks, dogs, cats, leopards, lions, zebras, monkeys, everything."
The royal cat watched every chase too. You could tell the cat liked them because she just purred and purred. A few days later, the cubs were up early, eating breakfast, when Miss Mutombo came to the door.
"Cubs, Garvey cubs,"
Tana answered the door.
"Is something wrong?"
"Yes, the king and queen want to see you right away."
The Garvey cubs left their breakfast and rushed over to the palace. When they got there, they saw the king was worried and upset.
"Cubs, I'm glad you came so quickly. I was outside this morning taking a walk, and you wouldn't believe what I saw."
"What? What is it, Your Majesty?"
"Well, I will just show you. Follow me."
They all followed the king out to Lake Lulalaba, near the forest.
"Cubs, I've never seen our animals behave like this before. This is the strangest thing I've ever seen."
The cubs were surprised and confused because here is what they saw.
"First, I saw a monkey run out of the forest chasing a leopard into the bushes. And then, the leopard ran out of the bushes and jumped into the lake and started swimming after a crocodile that was under the water. The leopard went under the water chasing him.
The next thing you know, that green and brown scaly crocodile came out of the water and tried to run after the small brown and white cat. The cat ran into the forest and the big slow crocodile followed it, chasing. After a few minutes, the cat came running out of the forest. When the cat got back to the grass, it started running after a big black and white zebra.
The zebra ran and jumped into the lake, and the little cat jumped in after it. They both swam across part of the lake, and the zebra got out of the lake and kept running into the forest. The cat was soaking wet, but it still chased the zebra into the forest."
The king was even more upset.
"My animals have gone crazy! They have gone crazy!"
Then Tamika said,
"Next, the zebra ran out of the forest. It ran straight in the direction of a big mean lion with huge sharp teeth."
The queen really loves zebras, and this really scared her.
"Oh no! That lion looks hungry! And look at those teeth! Oh no! The poor zebra!"
But when the zebra got close to the lion took off running, away from the zebra. The lion ran over a hill with the zebra chasing behind it. This was strange. Usually, it's the lion chasing zebras, but now the zebra was chasing a lion. Corinda said,
"Then the lion came up over the hill, running like crazy, but there was no zebra behind him anymore."
The queen screamed,
"Oh no! Here comes the lion! He must have got that poor zebra! Somebody stop this!"
Morel said,
"Then the lion started running after the little Luba girl, who was carrying water on her head in a bucket. When she saw the big lion, her eyes got big. She screamed and dropped the bucket and started running down the hill into some bushes. All you could hear was the lion roaring and the girl screaming."
The king and queen ran down the hill to rescue the girl. The king pulled his big sword out and waved it around.
"Don't worry, little girl. The king will rescue you from that big lion. I am coming."
But suddenly, the girl ran out of the bushes and up the hill straight to the king. When she reached him, she was breathing hard.
"King!"
"Yes, little girl. Are you all right?"
"Yes. Yes, Your Highness. I just want to tell you something."
"What? What is it, dear?"
She looked straight into the king's eyes. She reached out and touched his arm and then smiled.
"King, Tug, you are it!"
Then she took off running.
"What?"
Then the king remembered the video that the cubs gave him where the children were playing tag.
"Oh, you guys tricked me! That silly royal cat saw that animal chase video, then taught all the animals the game that you call tag! Ha ha ha! You tricked me this time! You really tricked me this time! Ha ha ha!"
The queen really thought that was funny. She was laughing so hard that she could barely stand up. But then the king looked at her and said,
"Queen, I don't know why you are laughing so much."
He tapped her on her arm.
"Because now you are it."
The king took off running down the hill so fast that one of his royal sandals flew off of his foot. Oh, and the last time anyone saw the queen, she had taken her royal slippers off and was laughing and chasing a huge rhinoceros across the green grassy field. Now, the Luba of Central Africa had a brand new game. They cheered and cheered.
Hooray! Hooray! Hooray for the Luba king and queen! Hooray for the Marcus Garvey Cubs! Hooray for the new game of tag! Hooray for Africa! Hooray! Hooray! Hooray!
Questions. Why did the king's guards pick N'Golo up off the ground? When the Cubs video recorded a big eagle flying down to the water, what was the eagle trying to do? What happened? Did the eagle get what he wanted? The king thought that his animals had gone crazy because they were all chasing each other. But what were they really doing? Last question. How did the animals learn about the game of tag?